felt upset, of course. And then after about a month, each of them faced this news differently. One of them felt, again, still angry, upset, depressed, and of course, blaming or asking why me? Why does this happen to me? Why did I get the cancer? The other gentleman, what he did was after a month, he thought about it, say, well, if only I have a year to live, what am I going to do? So he decided to quit his job and move back to his village.
然后在半年以后，前面那个人就真的去世了。然后又过了大概半年到一年之间，大概九个月或者什么，就大概一个时间，病人奇怪，我说我还有一年的时间，然后现在我没什么特别的感觉呢。然后他又去到医院去检查，结果同样那个医生发现很奇怪，他那癌块不但没有扩散，反而小了，当然他没有消失。So
the gentleman who was always angry and blaming, after half a year, he passed away. But the second gentleman who quit his job and then went back to his village, after 6 months, almost to a year, he's like, wow, I'm still here. What's going on? Why am I not dead, like the doctor said? So he went back to the doctors and said, well, what's going on? And the doctor found out that his tumor, his cancer tumor, has not expanded, but actually got smaller. It's still there, but it's gotten smaller.
后来这个故事发生了，我就不知道，因为前面的话是这是一件真实事情，发生在我的老家山东的。后来我不知道，也许他仍然是因为癌症去世的。但是从这前面知道这个故事，你就可以看到，不同的心理状态对你的身体的健康也是有很大影响。So
this is a true story, and this is a story from Dr. Wang's hometown, Shandong. And he said he just knows the first part of the story. He doesn't know what actually happened. Maybe the other gentleman also passed away. But if you just look at the first part of their life, that 1 year or half a year, you notice the difference, and that's the difference in their attitude and how they face the situation, face the news of having cancer.
好，那我们先谈到心理健康非常重要。那什么是心理健康？这个定义读起来非常的绕口啊，但是从基本上来讲，它就一个意思，就让你感到自己感觉比较满意、比较舒服的一种持续的心理状态，不是说今天舒服明天坏，或者今天不好明天好。
So what is mental health? Generally speaking, mental health is a continuous state of mind that is efficient and satisfied. That means that you have, it's a continuous pattern. It's not like today I'm happy, tomorrow I'm sad. It has to be overall.
第二部分讲是一个比较，就是讲的更具体一点啊。我想大家没必要记住这个定义的。我想强调的有两点，就最后才这一句话，就是能适应社会，并且与社会保持同步。这个可能会更重要。
就是如果一个人心理健康的话，他要和这个社会很协调，能够适应周围的环境的变化。The second one, specifically, mental health is the basis of psychological. The basis of psychological wellness is the wholeness and the congruency of emotion, purpose, behavior, and personality. But you don't have to remember that. That's a lot of jargon. But what you need to know is that to be mentally healthy, it's important to accept the ability to adapt, to cope, and keep pace with changes of society. Because society always changes, and if you keep up with that and are able to deal with changes, you should be feeling very well. They want to come. Lots of times, mental illness doesn't come about during times when there's not much happening in your life. Everything is stable, right? So there's not your behavior, your thinking, your attitude doesn't change much. So you don't detect it. But if there's major changes in your life, that's a lot of times when mental problems come into play. And that's when, depends on how you cope with the situation.
那么心理健康有哪些标准呢？我这列出来了五条。其实第一个可能会大家更能够接受或者比较常见啊，就是情绪的稳定与愉快。你就达到这个，才能说你的心理是不是健康。比如说一个人今天情绪非常非常好，结果明天就因为一点小事情，结果情绪非常的低落。那些小事情放在别人那里，可能就没这么情绪糟糕了。
might be a situation one day where something happened and you feel very sad or angry. But different people treat that situation differently. Some people say, oh, okay, well, that happened, I'll let it go. But some people, they don't do that. They hold on to that issue and hold on to that grudge and say, why this is happening? Who should I be blaming, or what's this have to do with me?
第二个呢是行为的统一，就是说你的做出任何的行为要和你的思路、和你想的那种是一致，要和周围的这个环境是一致。也比如说，在一个非常正式的场合，你的行为像一个小孩子一样，那你可能不是一个很健康的状态。The
second one is acts of harmonization. That how do you keep harmony with your surroundings, your situation? How do you behave? Is it age appropriate? Because if you something happened and you act like a child, your reaction is like very childish, then maybe that is, there's something wrong. You're not, you know, because you don't have the mental capacity to realize what's going on.
第三个说，良好的人际关系，这个也是非常很重要的。你可以说啊，我情绪挺好呀，我也和周围的环境好像蛮一致的，但是你和周围的同事总是天天吵架，啊，你和所有人的关系都不是那么理想。
The third one is having good relationships with other people. It could be your friends, your family, your co-workers. If you're always arguing with somebody, somebody always ticks you off, gets you angry, then that's not a very good sign.
第四条和良好的适应能力，我们前面已经重复了几次了，我在这不再说。最后一个呢，智力正常，这很大程度上是一个先天的因素啊，不属于我们今天讨论的范围。
The fourth one is good. Able to adapt, and we mentioned that earlier, so we're not going to expand on that. But the last one is normal intelligence or IQ. But we're not going to focus on that because that is definitely a different subject that needs more time. So we're just going to cover more of the four types.
那么心理前面讲的心理健康的标准，心理不健康会怎么样？我想在咱们中国人的这个平时谈话中，骂一个人首先上不是你这人精神病，不是神经病，这里所说的这个精神病。 其实和心理问题是完全两码事，心理问题绝对不等同于精神病。So
it's a very important point that we want to put out there that mental problems does not mean mental illness. That's a very big distinction between the two.
下面我可能要多一点谈这个常见的心理问题。啊，我这里把那个人呢加上一个引号，我说常见的心理问题是因人而异，不仅仅说是某一个人，因哪一个个体。 而且人群不同，也不一样。你比如说，在学生这个群体中，他所面临的心理问题，和在工作工作的人这个成年人这个群体中所面临的问题，可能有很大的。We're
going to talk a little bit about common psychological problems here, and we want to talk about in Dr. Wang's slide the word people. He put that in quotations because he wants to make a point out there to say that it depends on the person. Not everybody has the same psychological problems. Not everybody deals with their psychological problems the same way. It depends because, and everybody has different problems. If you're a student, then you have issues as a student, maybe with class, with your instructor, with whatnot. But what if you're working, then you might have a different set of problems. So there's that difference. It depends on the person.
今天如果是把这所有的每一种人群的问题都讲一下呢，可能没有足够的时间。那么我。
概括上讲，大概就分这前三个方面。Because we may have a very limited time to talk about different types today, we are going to focus on the first
three。第一个就情绪异常，这个呢，我也列出比较常见的是焦虑和抑郁。这个呢，在生活中是比较多见。一旦你遇到一个不开心的事情或者比较大的心理应激，最常见的反应就是焦虑、心慌，不知道该干什么。
Abnormal emotion is the most common in our life, and anxiety and depression. When we face challenges, and all of a sudden we feel anxiety and depressed.
第二个就是人际关系，这个前面我们也讲到，如果是你以前和大家相处关系都很好，最近发现我怎么和很多人都处不了，和有点矛盾，可能就出现。The
second one is a relationship with others. You may see that you have a very good relationship with your colleagues, your friends, and all of a sudden, there's problems. 第三就是睡眠障碍，这个是非常常见，尤其到了中年以后，再出现睡眠问题的时候，睡眠障碍是比较多见。其他的呢，还有一些比较少见，比如说那个进食障碍，吃东西少了，现在年轻女性这个比较多一点。
And the third one is a sleeping disorder. That's often seen in those who are past middle age. And your psychological problems often affect your sleeping patterns. And other ones may be eating disorders. That may happen to a lot of younger females.